In this video, we'll set up a Do More controller as an Ethernet IP explicit server and use another Do More as a client to access the data that's on that server. Instead of using two Do Mores though, we use a real Do More for the server and we use the Do More simulator for the client. Let's set up the server on the real Do More first. Here's an empty project and I'm already connected to the Do More. As always, we start with the system configuration. Under CPU configuration, we see the IP address is already set up. If it wasn't, we would just configure it here. We also need to enable the Ethernet IP server and click here to configure it. These defaults are fine for what we're doing. The key thing here is we can expose 8 different blocks of memory to the outside world. Let's enable blocks 1 and 5. We can make the block readable or writable. We'll leave ours set for both. We can choose which memory elements we want to expose. How about vMemory for this one, starting at element 80, and let's expose, 10 of those. Down here, it reminds me that those 10 elements run from V80 to V89, and it exposes 20 bytes of data since each V element is 2 bytes wide. Over here, we see the class, instance, and attribute information our client will need to access this data. Perfect. For block 5, let's expose some dMemory, and let's say it starts at element 200, and we'll expose 5 of those. Write this configuration out to the Do More, and we now have a Do More Ethernet IP explicit server that exposes 10 vMemory locations and 5 dMemory locations to any Ethernet IP client out there. The client only needs to know this guy's IP address and the class, instance, and attribute of the 2 blocks of memory. We'll leave this copy of Do More Designer up and running so we can keep an eye on the server and start a new copy of Do More Designer for the simulated client. We want this to be a simulated project, and we'll go ahead and connect to the simulator. We won't actually be using this view of the simulator for this project, so we'll move that out of the way. Just know that we are connected to it just like a real Do More, and that we'll be writing our project to it. Now, you don't treat the simulator any different than a real Do More, so once again, we start with the system configuration. This IP address shown here is just one of the IP addresses I have on this computer. I actually have 3 NIC cards in this computer. Now, it doesn't really matter which one pops up here. Windows will route all of the IP traffic from the simulator to the correct port when a time comes. There's nothing else to do here or under I/O configuration. And of course, instead of the usual I/O configuration screen here, we just see a screenshot of the simulator since this is all the I/O there is in a simulator and you can't change any of it. And there's nothing to do under module configuration since there aren't any plug-in modules in the simulator. Under device configuration, we could use the built-in Ethernet IP device, but it's best to get in the habit of creating a new Ethernet IP device for each piece of hardware. It simplifies the handling of the TCP/IP connections inside the Do More. New device, Ethernet IP client, give it a name, we'll call it Do More Server, easy. There's nothing to do under I/O mappings or memory configuration, so we're done. So all we need to do here is drop an explicit Ethernet IP instruction on a rung and fill in the blanks. We want to talk to our new Do More server we just set up, and he's at this IP address. Here's the Ethernet IP information from the V block memory we had on the server. We just enter that here. And we want to get that block of memory from the server. We'll enable the instruction on a contact edge, and we'll use these status bits. Let's put those server V memory locations into V memory here, but let's put that at V0 on this client. We'll put the number of response bytes received here, and we expect a maximum of 10 V words, which is 20 bytes. Accept that, and add a contact to trigger it. Now, to access the D memory block, it's the exact same thing, so I'm going to copy this instruction, paste it here, edit it. The only difference is this instance number has changed. Let's go ahead and change the status bits, and let's put that result in memory starting at D100. The number of bytes read will be in D99, and we're still expecting 20 bytes total. Accept that, add a contact to trigger the instruction, and write all this out to the simulated Do More. Let's bring up a data view for the V memory, enter its triggering contact, the first few elements, I'm using control return to do this quickly, and a number of bytes read. Let's bring up another data view for the D memory, enter his contact, the first few elements of him, and the number of bytes read for that operation. Make sure we're running and that the status is on. Let's switch over to the server and modify the V memory and the D memory, switch back to the client, and trigger the instructions to read those memory locations from the server. And sure enough, we get exactly what we expect. Flip back over to the server, change the numbers, flip back to the client, issue another read again, and we see the expected result. Easy. Suppose we wanted this simulated client to write to the Do More server. How do we do that? Well, we just go into this instruction, change this get to a set, and pick the block of memory locations we want to send to the server. And if we want to expose more memory locations on the server, we just change the configuration. And remember, all we did to allow clients to access the server's memory was enable the server back in the system configuration. Once we turn it on, we can forget about it. We don't have to do anything. The Do More takes care of all of the client requests for us in the background. The Do More makes all of this so easy. And how cool is it that we can simulate one or even both ends of the Ethernet IP messaging, which means you can set up and configure both ends of an Ethernet IP system with no hardware in hand. And yes, that simulator comes free with the Do More Designer software. There is no extra charge for the simulator. If you have any questions, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support staff there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis. Spend less, do more with Automation Direct.